Hello, dear students. Today we will discuss about the subject that is advertising management, and in this we will discuss the basics of advertisement. Advertisement is a very common term which we use in our daily life, and this is a very important subject in the marketing management MBA third semester. So first we learn certain important parts of the advertisements and some functions of the advertisements. Why do we use advertisements? Benefits of advertisements and the different things. Okay, so to proceed further, what is advertisement? Advertisement is only one element of promotion mix, but it often considered prominent in the overall marketing mix design. So you can see that advertisement is part of the promotion mix. A promotion mix consists of the four elements like advertisement, personal selling, sales, promotion and publicity. But this is the most prominent element of the promotion mix because we widely see advertisement in our life. So what is advertisement? To define further, we can say advertisement is the dissemination of information by non-personal means through paid media where the source is sponsoring organization. So in advertisement, you can see there is a presentation. Presentation is what kind? Presentation is non-personal. That means company is not coming to you personally. Rather, the advertisement from company is coming to you personally through a media. Media is always a paid media, and the source of a sponsor, that means the name of the company, is known. So this is what advertisement is. Now we come to the personal selling. Personal selling is through face-to-face contacts between the audience and the employees, between the sponsoring organizations, employees and the customers. Sales promotion, we come to the third point, that is sales promotion. Sales promotion is also a variety of activities other than publicity, personal selling, advertisement and publicity, which stimulate consumer purchasing and dealer effectiveness. This means with the help of sales promotion, you influence the consumer purchase towards a particular product or service. And publicity is the fourth point. Publicity is the dissemination of information. Dissemination, this means information is reaching to the large audiences, the large persons, the large people by personal or non-personal means. And it is generally not directly paid by the organizations. For example, you go to a company to buy a car and they give you a big key. For example, you are the first buyer in the city. So the news comes in the newspaper that X person has owned the X company's, yeah, Hyundai's car or Maruti's car. The first model was delivered to a particular person. So that news comes to the paper, and this is the publicity. This is the example of publicity. Now we come to the next slide. Some definition of the advertisements. As we have already discussed, it is any, according to the American Marketing Association, it is any form of non-personal presentation. That means presentation is not personal, non-personal. We are promoting idea, goods and services. What is promoted? Any idea, any goods or any service can be promoted. And the sponsor is always identified. Sponsor is known to the audience or the public. So this is what advertisement is. Some basic elements of the advertisement, like it is a mass communication reaching to a large group of consumers. So what is advertisement? Advertisement is for mass communication. Personal selling is for selected group of people. Advertisement is for mass communication, reaching to more number of people. It makes mass production possible, as advertisement helps in generating sales. So with the help of advertisement, sales increases, production is possible. It is a non-personal communication. We have already discussed. It is a commercial communication because always helps in increase helps in increase in sales. Advertisements can be economical, as it reaches to the large group of people with lesser cost. Although there is a controversy on this, that advertisement increases the cost of the product, but that we will discuss later. The communication happens speedily. Speedily communication happens, and advertisement is an identified communication. That means the known, the company, the sponsor is always known. The name of the sponsor is always known. So we come to the next slide, that is what should be included in the advertisements. Advertisement should include the following points. This is very important because this will help you when you will design the advertisements for your company. The information should benefit the buyers. The information which should be included in the advertisement should benefit the buyer. It should give them more satisfactory expenditure of their rupees. That means with the help of advertisements, a kind of cognition in their mind that whatever we have spent on the product is right. It should suggest a better solution to the problem. You can see the various advertisements. For example, you see the advertisements of falling hair, and in that a hair oil comes, which suggests, for example, Indulekha suggests the solution to the falling hair problems and other hair problems. So this is what? This is communicated with the help of the advertisement. The content of the advertisement is within the control of the advertiser, not the medium. So what should come in the advertisement should be decided by the advertiser only. The advertisement should persuade the buyers. They should attract the buyers to buy the product and services. If they are not able to do this, advertisement will be the total waste of money, and function of the advertisement is to increase the profitable sales volume. So advertisement should help in increasing the sales. Then only the penny spent on the advertisement will give certain return to the company. But it should be taken in the mind that advertisement proportion, advertisement expenses should not be increased disproportionately. That means excessive advertisement expenses may create problem in the budget of the organization. So we come to the next slide, which says what includes in the form of the messages. So you can include newspaper, advertisement can come in newspaper, they can come in magazines, they could be on radio, they could be on television, they could be in the form of circulars, through mails, by person, through tradesmen, or inserts in the packages, leaflets, dealer help materials could be the advertisement, window displays at the counters, billboards, signboards, novelties, label stages, and other literatures which is accompanying the merchandise, the goods or the service will be in the form of the advertisements. So all these things can be in the form of the advertisements. Aap dekh sakte hain, newspaper, magazine, radio, television, dealer help material, label, signs, etc. all comes in the form of the advertisements. And what should not be in the advertisement? So we can say advertisements cannot predict with accuracy what result of these all the advertisement effort will produce. So advertisement is not a science that you say I do this kind of advertisement and this will be the increased result or the increased sales. So it cannot be predicted like this. Advertisement is not a game, because advertisement is done properly. It is for the benefit of the buyers and sellers. It is not only for the buyers, it is not only for the sellers. Advertisements is not a toy, because every advertisement you have to pay money, you have to put certain funds. So advertisers should try to generate certain sales revenue post advertisements, and they are not designed to deceive. It is very important to know that you should not give faulty or false information in the advertisements, because and this will predict a wrong image of the company. So advertisement should be honest. So all these things should not be included in the advertisements and should be excluded. And what activities are not part of the advertisement? So you can say the exhibitions, demonstration, trade fair, shows, these are not advertisements. Sample you are giving with the products are not advertisements. The payment of advertisement allowances you are giving to the staff is not advertisements, and any entertainment of the customers not the advertisements. So we have come to know the various basics of the advertisements. We have come to know the definitions of the advertisements. We have come to know the what comes in advertisement, what does not comes in the advertisement. We have come to know the various platforms here we could give the advertisements. So basic understanding is developed through the help of this video lecture about the advertisements. I hope you have understood it and we'll continue the subject in the next lecture.